In this video, we will go over the different ways to get data into Galaxy. One of the easiest ways to do it is through shared data. So if you go to the taskbar, click on shared data, you can go to the data libraries. Here you see we have two libraries that are available, Galaxy Training and Galaxy Training Resistance. If we click on the name of the first one, for instance, it will open up this screen, and here you will see the files that are part of this data set. You can either select all files, deselect all of them, or just select individual files. If you want to add these two FastQ files to our history, we just click on To History up here. We will do it as datasets now. Collections is also possible. And when you do this, it will tell you to select the history. So the unnamed history is the history that was open when I started Galaxy, or you can also create a new one by just typing the name of the new history. So I will just call it Neisseria and click on import. Now you see it says that the selected data sets were imported into history. So if we go back to analyze data, we will see that those two data sets are now in our history, which is called Neisseria. Another way to get data into Galaxy is by using the data uploader. There are two ways to get to this data uploader. The first one is go to the category Get Data here in the Tools menu, and then upload file from your computer. This will open up the data uploader. I'm going to close this now to show you the second way. So the second way is going to this icon here to the right of Tools. And if you just click on it, it will open up the same window. It's a bit easier to do it this way than the other way. Here you can see you have two ways to upload files. You can either choose a local file or an FTP file. So local files are useful for files that are not larger than, say, 1 to 2 gigabytes, and they will be uploaded through your web browser. If you have files that are bigger than 1 to 2 gigabytes, you will have to do it through an FTP file. So I will show you the local file first. So you just click on Choose Local File, and you get a Windows Explorer here, which you can just use to select the files that you want. You click on Open, and they will be added to the screen here. So you have the name of the files that you want to upload, the size. The type is set to Auto Detect, which is the best in 99% of the cases. But if for some reason you would want to manually specify the type that these files need to be, you can just do it here. You can also do some genome settings and additional settings. And in the bottom, you can also set the type for all files. So if, for instance, you have 30 files that you want to upload and you want to set the type for each of them, you don't have to go manually through each and every one of them. You can just say, I want all these files to be of this type, and it will set that type for all the files that you're going to upload. So the only thing remaining is clicking Start here, and it will start uploading the files. So you can either wait until all the files have been uploaded, or you can just close this window, and you will see that they're still going to be added to the history in the background. So the last file is uploading now. It's processing. And it's done. So now these files are uploaded to Galaxy. Now, as I said, this won't work for files larger than 1 to 2 gigabytes. You will notice that this is the case when you're trying to upload one of these files and you get an error while uploading the file. It just means that the web browser thinks it's taking too long to upload this file and will just terminate the connection. When you have this happen, you need to do it through FTP. To upload something through our FTP server, you have to have an FTP client. And due to security measures that are in place, the connection to the server has to happen using a key file. This key file is a personal identification file that is used instead of a password for authentication. In order to get this key file, you have to send a simple request to our team at this email address, and the key will be created by us and then sent to you by mail. So if you look at the mail, it looks like this. You will see that there's a file attached called ID_RSA. It also specifies the host for which this key is created, and the username you have to use. So you can save this file anywhere on your computer. You can also name it anything that you like. Just make sure that you know where it is located and that you have a backup of this file, because we do not have any backups for these files. Next, you have to open your FTP client. I will demonstrate it with WinSCP here. So it's important that you select the file protocol to be SFTP. The host name is mentioned in the mail. So in this case, it's going to be BioIT Galaxy Prod. The username is also in the email. And as I said, we don't have a password but a key. So we have to go to advanced. And then in SSH, you can click on authentication. And here you can specify the private key file to use. So here you just have to browse to the location where you saved your key file. And you will see that by default, it's going to look for PuTTY private key files, so PPK files. The key that we sent is not in this format yet. So what you have to do is just select all files. And you see here, I called my key ID_RSA_galaxy, just to know what this key is for. It makes it easier for me to remember what the key is for. So you just select the key file that you saved, you open it, and then it will tell you that it was expecting PuTTY format, but the key is in OpenSSH format. So we would like to convert this file to PuTTY format so that WinSCP and other FTP clients can use it. So you just say OK. OK again to this message. And then PuTTYGen opens. You can enter a key passphrase if you want to. This adds some more security, because nobody will be able to use this key unless they provide the passphrase. For this tutorial, I'm not going to enter a passphrase, but it is advised that you do enter a passphrase here, but also make sure that you note this passphrase down somewhere, or that you save it somewhere safe, because if you lose the passphrase, your key is useless. So we'll just click here on Save Private Key. Now you will ask me, am I sure that I want to save it without protecting it with a passphrase? Just say yes. In this case, I am. And I will give it the name ID_RSA_galaxy.ppk. Don't forget to add the extension here. And you click on Save. So now this key has been saved. We can close PuTTYGen. And we can go to WinSCP back and now select the PPK file. So we have selected it, we click on OK, and then login. The first time that you connect to the server, he will ask you to verify that this is indeed the server you're connecting to. So we just click yes here. And now it has connected. So if we go to the location where we saved our files, maybe you want to upload these two files here. So on the right hand side is the file system on the server. On the left hand side is your local file system. So we open the folder on the server with our username, and then just drag and drop the files that we want to upload left to right. And you will see it will start uploading files. Once the files have been uploaded, you can close WinSCP, or you can use any other FTP client that you like. And we can go back to Galaxy. Now we just go back to the same data upload. But instead of choosing the local file, we can now choose an FTP file. So if we click this, we will see the two files that we just uploaded through the FTP client. We can just select all of them, close this window, and you will see that they're added again to this window. We click on Start. And this goes much faster, as the files were already uploaded to the server to begin with. We close it, and you will see that the two files have been added to the history. So these are three ways you can get data into Galaxy. So you either have the shared data, but that already needs to be in Galaxy and shared with you by somebody else. You can upload files up to 1 to 2 gigabytes through the data uploader, or larger files first through the FTP client and then through the data uploader. And with this, we're at the end of this video.